Excuse me. Harvey, was that you? Was that you? I think that was you. Alright. Don't you look at me like that. You wanna fight? You wanna fight? Oh, you high. Oh, hi, little Herb. Hey, oh, the Nova. Oh, the Herb. Alright. Oh, yeah, I'm live. Let me just send out some tweets really quick and we'll get this shit show started. We are live with. That'll work. Then I take the picture. Actually, you know what? We'll take the new picture. And then. Alright, so I got the new picture. We'll put the new picture on. Alright. We'll tweet. Sorry about that. Menel is deciding to go on his third run. We have upgraded Menel a little bit. What do we get? Gloves of Thievery, Goggles of Object Reading, Decanter of Endless Water, Emerald Pen. What else? Some spell components. Oh, he upgraded his ritual book. So now if he stays down there, he can pretty much stay down there forever with the Decanter of Endless Water and the Goodberry spell. Oh, he did get one swig of... He did get a pull off of that super potion thingy. So I gotta go to my character sheet. Inventory, manage inventory. Greater. Nope. Superior. Potion of greater healing. Alright. We will just import again. Solo 3. Alright, so I added the potion of greater healing. We are good. So he's been working with the Prophets of the Natural Order. And they have been... they told him about their... Well, he already knew about the secret entrance from Pethral. And Vincent might have let it slip out after feeding him more and more rust monster thoraxes, which apparently is his delicacy. So, What we've been doing is we've been plotting on how to safely get this base open. So they will allow me to go through with them. As soon as this opens, this closes. And one of these guys, actually probably both, are going to anchor a piton, and we will get lower down slowly. So we have about 1,000 feet of rope. And I... should get a horn. I think a horn would work. Yeah, a horn would be a good idea. I'll blow on a horn when I get to the bottom. So, working with the prophets, they will lower me down. Slowly. Slide down, and then when I see the bottom, I'll blow the horn, which I have in my hand. And if I see the spikes on the wall, I would blow it. So, because they're lowering me slowly, I'd be able to stop about here. And then, from there, I have pittons. Pittons. I should have pittons. Please let there be pittons. Haha. I can take 2 pittons. And I could do 4 pittons actually. So what I'll do is I'll put a spike here. Oh, that's not the right one. I want to do this. I put a spike here. I put a spike here. I could put a rope across. Just do a straight line. Horribly straight line. There we go. And then around here, I could do a looser line. Something to grab some slack onto. So this would be something to grab onto. And then how many iron spikes did I bring? So that's 4 pittons right there. I'll hammer those in, but I'm above Undermountain, so no random encounter spots. I'll have to draw this up later. And let's see. So I need... down to 6... of those. And then I could just hammer in a bunch of spikes. don't know about those yet. Sorry. So, I got two stop gaps right here. They did tell me that there's potentially a trap. Will I be able to spot it? We'll find out. No, I will not be able to spot it. So I would step closer slowly, and that would be a dexterity saving throw. Sweet. I fall into the 20-foot deep pit. Alright. So there's a 20-foot deep pit. I just fell, which is roll 2d6. That's 5 damage. Token, let's do everyone in the visual, and then owner, and then AC to make it easier. Alright, so I fell into the trap. I climb out of here. I mean, I do a pittance still. Actually, I'll just do iron spikes and slowly just climb up. Although irons, so I'll do an athletics with advantage because of iron spikes. One more time to climb up. So that was 10 feet. I am back up. So now I know where the trap is. So I will put spikes down. That should be good. Could be used, so that is 10-20 feet of rope. Rope. Rope, 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 rope. Where are my ropes? There's my ropes. That's 20 feet. Another 20 to go down. Anchored on these. And we'll just draw another 10 feet across here. So I have a way to stop it. I'll climb down, pull the spikes out. Knock them loose because they're a liability, so that is minus 5 spikes. Minus 5 spikes. I am pretty much down to 100 feet of rope, which could be a problem. And then I would go ahead and open the bottom lock. The door opens. And then that's when I start hearing the booms. Every time there's no rope, so I could go away. I don't know. I need the chain. So I have to throw the rope down after I tie it up. And once I tie it, I start to lower myself down in a rig. So, I'll time it with the booms. I will get advantage because I will be lowering myself down. Because what I can do, I could tie myself off around my waist and then loop it through and then just slowly lower myself down. And I could wrap my arm around the rope to make sure each time I go down, there would be no way back up. But I'd be lowering myself down right over where I want to be, which is the head. So this would be an advantage. But plus 50, 75. Another athletics. Slowly. 65. Athletics. Down to 50. So I get it to the head. And I could tie it off. Because that's 50, 50, and I still have 10 feet. With 10 feet, by the way, booms of lightning are constantly in here. All right. So I would stay anchored on. I would pitten myself into the head, or the headless part. So there's two more pittens. I'll do three. There's three pittens into the head of the statue. So I can stay anchored without falling off. So I'm good there. And then it would be athletics to climb out to the arm. But keep in mind, I am anchored with just a little slack. So this will be a straight athletics. Actually, this is me balancing on the arm, so I'll say acrobatics. Don't fall, but I basically grab onto the arm. Try to get myself back up. Doesn't help. Keep trying to get back up. Wow, I suck at this. Come on. I can get up. Alright, so I would get back up. Could tie myself to the elbow. And give myself like 5-10 feet at the elbow. And then climb out to the rest. Once I climb out to the rest, I can do get one out there one more time, get to the hand. There's constant lightning going off. I'll pull out, and it's shooting down. It never shoots up. It shoots down. And I have ...50 feet of chain. In 50-foot increments. So what I could do is wrap it around, the hand. Actually, you know what? I'll wait. I will observe for about 30 minutes to try to time it out. So I get the timing down after just constantly listening to the booms. Just sitting above the hand, watching it shoot out onto random parts of the ground. There's no rhyme or reason for where it's shooting, which is why it's constantly just hitting all over the room. So could I pull the chain out? Sorry, grab me there. Ooh. Fritz has a good idea. All right. So I have a 50-foot long chain. And I have it looped at the end already. I want to basically throw it around the wrist of where the lightning comes from, around the hand and the wrist.
Yeah.
And try to just toss the chain.
As long as the chain is making contact with the point the lightning is coming from and the ground, you should be good. Just if the lightning goes off before.
I know.
Yeah. It's going to be attracted to the metal because path of least resistance, right?
So I'm going to see, I'm going to give myself a 50-50 chance of getting struck by lightning here because I'm the one holding the chain. I am tied off. I have 5 feet of rope from the elbow. So I got a little bit of wiggle room. So if I fall, I'm just going to be dangling 5 feet at the elbow. So red is bad. And red is bad. All right. So I got struck by lightning, which is a very, very fun feeling. Fabby lightning bolt. Oh, 86. Might kill me outright. Oh, that hurt. So I'm down to 4 hit points.
But did you successfully get the chain around the wrist?
Let's give me an acrobatics. Yes, it did.
All right. So now that one has a direct path to the ground.
So it's just going to constantly short into the ground. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and drink my lovely greater potion of healing already. That's not much. Oh, I had 4 left. Apply healing. I'm going to heal myself. Do I just burn my heal spells and then probably rest on the head? So I got to climb back up. That's going to be athletics. I'm tied off, so I'll make it back up and get back on the head. I'm going to take a short rest. So I get, Really?
You're very not lucky on this.
No, I'm not. All right. So I got one hit dice left. I've rested. I burned a potion. I'm going to untie the elbow. Make sure I don't fuck up. I'm still anchored at the neck. Oh, I'm good. I'll come out here, tie around the elbow.
Wait. The statue's neck or your neck?
The statue's neck. Okay. There's three pittons. There's three pittons on the neck. And I'm anchored on the
people all have different kinks, okay? I want judgment else kink.
All right, so I'm going to go ahead and tie off at the elbow. Give me my 5 feet. Nope. All right, I fall down, but I don't fall. I'm holding on to it. I'm going to try to balance, and I fall. So that'll be 20 feet down. And there's still lightning coming from this hand. But luckily, it rarely ever touches the base of the statue.
Yeah, that's what you told Midget last time. Look what happened.
Yep, give me 1 second. Oh, good. I didn't get... All right. I'm going to go ahead and try to climb back up. Nope. I'm at 25 feet. Oh, fuck. I need that. I gotta try again. I don't have the strength to climb back up. Take a rest. See if I get shocked. Nope, good. It's a 95%. Oh, interesting. Sorry. Alright. I'm gonna try climbing again. After taking a little bit of a breather. Get about 15 feet up. One last push. Didn't make much leeway. But I didn't fall. Last push. Barely make it up. Because I'm tied off on the rope. Alright, so that sucks. There you go, Fritz. Sorry about that. Alright. Acrobatics. So actually, no, I'll take a breather. I'll try to walk, balance and tire off around the elbow. I get to the elbow and tie it off. I give myself 5 feet. I'm going to acrobatics, and I slip, and I'm hanging by 5 feet. Let's see if I get struck by lightning. Nope. Climb back up that 5 feet. I do. I'm back on the elbow. Acrobatics back out. I could crawl back out there with a 10. And then I'm just going to tie myself at the wrist, actually. So I have like 1 foot of leeway. With the 1 foot of leeway, I can grab the chain and try to throw it. And this is going to be a 50-50 chance of it hitting me. Ones are bad. Oh, thank fuck. So I throw the chain, wrap it around. Let's see if it's around it. I drop the chain onto the ground. So it has a 1 in 4 chance of hitting the chain. So if I go to pick it up, I am going to get shocked. I mean, I have half of it. I'll untie myself and try to crawl back. I'll crawl this time instead of barely make it. Slowly crawl. Okay. Alright. So it's hitting randomly on the left side. And every fourth chance it hits the pile of. So left, right side is, I'm almost assured I'm not going to get struck. But I, not 100%. I mean, it's like I probably have a 5% chance of getting struck. So what I can do is lower myself down with the rope on the right side. Do the elevator trick like I did last time. Which I'll do. Slowly lower myself down on this side. Slowly lower myself down. And then slowly lower. Oh, hold on. Do I get struck? Nope. And slowly lower myself down. Fuck. Not enough. Alright. And then see if I get struck again. Nope. Alright. Lastly, slowly lower myself down. Barely make 5 feet. See if I get struck. And then I make it down. Untie myself. Alright, so this side, I have a very low chance. So from here, I will take some cloth from my clothes and wrap it around the hammerhead. God damn it, Fritz. Oh, I see that video. All right. So I need an iron spike and my hammer. So I'm going to drop an iron spike here. See if I make noise. I'm going to dampen it with the cloth, so I'm going to just give myself around a 5% chance, which I'm good, and see if I get struck by lightning from the left side. I do not. Go ahead and drop another one right here. Hammering. No noise. Struck by lightning. I'm on the right side now, so I have a very, very low chance. All right, I'm still alive. Another iron spike. There. And I'm putting them in the corners of the see if I make too much noise. Barely make that one. And see if I get struck. I'm good. So I'm trying to basically, like, just a basic, like, perimeter around this statue. And just encircle it with iron spikes so they'll be more drawn to the center. No noise, no shocky. Since I am closer to the chain, though, now, I will up my potential for getting shocked. No noise. Still good. Closer to the wrist. Closer to the chain. No noise. No shocky. I'm really playing with fire here. Just want to see. That's not the right spot. I want to do it right here. All right. No noise, no shocky. Moving a little further away, but I'm still in the high risk zone. No noise. Oh, so close. No noise. No shocky. All right. So we're well. One. So right here. So go right here. I'm further away from the wrist now, thankfully. Make sure that's not the spot. All right. No noise, no shocky. No noise, no shocky. And here's where I'm probably going to get shocked. I have a higher chance here because I can get struck by both. And I'm creating an anchor. Noise first. No noise. No shocky. All right. I'd back away. Try to figure out how the hell I'm going to do this.
At this point, there's no easy way.
No, there isn't.
What kind of armor do you have?
Serpent scale. So it's like
metal. Snake skin. You take off all your metal, you lower your risk, but you're also defenseless / no armor. It depends how risky you want to go.
Well, it's serpent scale. It's actually snake skin.
Is it snake skin? Oh, yeah.
It's enchanted snake skin.
Well, it's up to you. Lower the risk with metal.
He's holding a chain.
Holding a chain. I'm holding an iron spike and a sledgehammer.
which are both metal.
Yep. I mean, that...
Who gave him a metal hammer? Who's the idiot that gave him a metal hammer?
Stone would have broke. I think I'm good with just half the room. Because that opens up this door, and this door. Yeah. And there's, and there's no doors on the other side. Well, there's whatever this door leads to, but there's nothing else on the other side.
Yeah, those are all the doors you can see, by the way.
Yeah.
So that you're basically okay, except if you go in the left room in the bottom. Left bottom room.
And then what you could really do if you really wanted is get another group down here, take a chain from the wrist, and tie it to each spike.
I wonder why he doesn't want to do it. So I would say this job's half done.
So the chain is on the wrist of the statue. So like it's on the wrist of the statue, and the chain is literally dangling to the all the way almost to the ground. And then while it's dangling there, there is a little a Faraday cage essentially around it. So where if it does shock, it's only going to shock to the metal points. And then what you could, if you get really, really innovative, what you could do is go down and make like a zip line from the neck to like one of the safe spots outside the Faraday cage.
He's making a Christmas tree, guys, with lightning.
Yep. I mean, it stops half the room from being shocked, which is the good side. And I mean, at most, you probably have.
And I will say this: electricity just works with the least resistance. So this and the shortest path, this definitely works.
Yes, this is not a permanent solution, Fritz. It will eventually probably melt or corrode or just completely give out.
Yeah, because you gotta keep in mind this is doing it every.
Six to 12 seconds.
Yeah. So this thing gets very hot. It's a lot of energy. I'll be more surprised if it lasts a month, to be honest.
So what it would do is probably I give about 5 to 6 seconds. I would say 5 or 6 sessions before it gives out.
Unless he made an adamant time, then he'll be fine.
Okay, so if we went adamantine chain, the price is 500 gold or 350 gold for the adamantine. And then, no, it's 500.
500 for adamantine in general, so.
So it'd be 500 and. How much is the chain?
I think it's 25 gold or something like that.
By the way, I am out of chain. Give me a second, and I'm out of rope. Wait, no, I lowered myself down. So I still have my rope. The chain is gone, and the chain is gone. How much is the chain? Doesn't say. All right, I'll have to look later.
5 feet of chain costs 5 gold. Or 10 feet of chain, sorry.
10 feet of chain costs 5 gold, so it'll be 505 gold to make an adamantine chain that only goes 10 feet.
Yep.
I dropped 50-foot chains on both sides, and the other side is... Yeah.
If you want a permanent solution, that's how you're going to do it.
Yep. This will give us 6 sessions, so.
Yeah, and that's assuming people use it.
Yep.
Rubber or boots. That's if you get out, too. They don't know if you did it yet.
Excuse me, sir. Bro. Sir. You you are being a little, sir. Excuse me.
Hey, sir. I don't like how you're talking to me right now, Tarnis.
I am trying to play a game right now, okay? I am playing I'm not playing Dungeons and Doggos. I'm playing Dungeons and Dragons.
Alright.
Let's go.
Go
on. Thank you.
I like all that right. Southwick. Being attacked by a cow.
Alright. His name, we call him Mazier Moo every now and then.
God.
Alright. So, I have three doors. I don't know where the fuck to go.
So, if you ever talked to Pethro, he did, if you know, he went through here and went north.
He did go north. Alright.
And he would have told you eventually you have to go east once you see a hallway that, like, forks in, like, six different directions.
Okay, so I'm gonna do I'm going west.
Of course you are.
By the way, I am because it was alright. So the question is, from here, what was the magic mouth phrase I was going to use? I'm going to use Memento Mori, and I'm going to ritual cast magic mouth on the ground.
How many did you have of those? 5?
10.
10?
Yep.
Yeah, Peter will definitely need that.
So I'm going to ritual cast Magic Mouth. And whenever you say the phrase Memento Mori, even if it's whispered, or couldn't I just say that anytime a Memento Mori or Shield and Shroud Recovery signet ring come within 5 feet of it.
Let me double check the magical mouth.
Yeah, let's look at magical mouth because I want to. Magic mouth.
No, a message that is uttered when trigger condition is met. Okay, so trigger condition, what can trigger condition be?
As general or as detailed as you like, it needs to be based on visual or audible conditions.
A ring would be visible.
Yep, it would be visible.
You can check them out to speak whenever. Oh, yeah.
You can be visible. Yeah, that's fine.
So whenever somebody with a Memento Mori or a Shield and Shroud Recovery Guild Signet Ring gets within 5 feet of this so the dead center of the intersection, so pretty much anyone who comes within these, it'll say, Menel went west, in a whisper. And they're going to get freaked out. All right.
Just, Menel was here.
No. Menel was here. I'm mainly doing it to tell people which direction I went.
Okay, wait. I have a question. Can that pen, what does the pen do again?
The pen only when it writes on paper.
Oh, it's only paper. Gotcha.
Yeah, it has to be on parchment paper, all that. So I'm going to write in, you know what, I'll spend some time writing in the book about how I anchored the right side of the statue. So we'll have notes on in my book and in my parchment, on a parchment, that I anchored the statue on the right side. We'll just say door side. There we go. I got a stealth, by the way. Oh, I forgot. Advantage, but I'm good. All right. To the left or to the right? Peek around the corner. Profits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is a sword glowing on.
Is it back there though?
No, it is not, but I just see a sword on there. The question is, would the prophets have shared that information with me? Probably not. And there is a porticlus right there, and I don't like that. I will make notes about a porticlus and a sarcophagus with a sword. A very large sword. And then he would go north. Which, this is actually an over-under. So there's three pillars. There's a bunch of doors. Listen to this door. Nothing on that side. Listen to this door. Nothing on that side. Left or to the right? Left or to the right? I'm going to the right. Which I'm going to copy, and I believe this puts me into the N territory. Alright, I'm going into stealth because I'm always walking very quietly. There's a door there, stairs there, stairs there. Up, down, up, right, down. I'm going right. Stealth, and I see light. Door. Light, which I won't get near, or just go in a giant circle. Door, right. God, so many fucking directions. There's a toilet. I've heard stories of toilets. Stairs going up. Oh, hey, I did a circle. Oh. I'm going to stealth again because I am just slowly sneaking. Door, stairs, door, door. Stairs, another toilet. think I went too far. All right, up, down, left. Or up, down, right. Up. I'm sorry, I thought I hit my mute button in time. All right. Door. I'll listen to the door. Do I hear anything on the other side? No, I do not. Keep going in a circle. I see a wall of darkness. I see a toilet, I see a stairs, and I see, oh, hold up. Listen to this door. Oh, I meant to do it once. Best ability, don't hear anything. I open it up. Aha! All right. Way to get through to that side looks like, ooh, hold on, that is a big circle. And there's the other toilet, that's just a big circle. I look at doors. I'll probably go. Well, see, the thing is, I'll probably go east because that's the only way I can go. So, copy this. He is a terrible, terrible ranger. I know this.
He's supposed to be a ranger, right?
Yep.
Wait, Menel's a ranger?
No. Yeah.
Who knew?
All right. North. North. I'm gonna wisdom saving throw really quick. I don't remember this place. Up, 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 down.
You flip the coin, boys. Where did you go?
Up, up, up. I'm going up, up.
Up, down, down, left, right, A, B.
What? There is a wall of darkness. Now I remember the wall of darkness trick. So I take out a torch. I don't light it. I put it through. Come back. I look at the torch. The torch is still there. I put the torch on the ground. Make sure that there's ground on the other side. I look at the other side. I'm like, oh, sweet. I didn't die. And then it comes to stairs. I get close to the stairs, and immediately my mind begins to jog because this is the misty platform. So basically, like, fog is going down the stairs, and there's a ghost at the top. I remember this one specifically because I made notes about it.
Alright, so what are you going to do now?
Yep. I know where I'm at.
You know where you're at, but do you know where you're going to go out, or are you going to keep going?
Well, I have... stealth. Oh, I'm good. Fuck. This was the door. Wait, I know where I'm going now. It's going to be a long roundabout way because I do not want to deal with those fuckers right now. Go all the way down. All the way up. I am expecting a skeleton to be hovering there, but there is no longer a skeleton there. There is just a pile of bone ash or bone dust. That's new. I will spend time and write it in my journal and in my book.
You want to do anything else there?
Why would I? I've already checked the throne. Oh, wait. Do I have the perception to see this? I do. The foot of this is slightly open. From when the last group, I think, episode two, came through. And they put the skeleton together. And they pulled the treasure, but they never really closed the throne. So I'm gonna perception the door. I'm good. Open the door. Because I know where I'm at. I think I'm... Hey, dead guy. I give him a high five.
That's fucked up. Teasing the dead that they're dead.
I'm not teasing them. I'm just giving the dude a high five. High five. I see that there's still a roaring fire continuing. Give me 1 second.
How much gold do you have on you?
24? I remember this door. I am going to lock the top lock.
Please do.
With the key. I don't want to leave.
Lock or unlock, you said?
I'm going to lock it. All right, I know this little fucker's in here. I'm going to run through.
So you're going to dash through it?
I'm going to dash through it with the and stick to the side. So. Oh, you asshole. You're an asshole. I need to make a wisdom saving throw. Because Fritz is a dick.
I like how you still have yourself over there, Menel, in the base.
Oh, hey, dude. Bye, dude. All right. So, I need to go ahead and make a wisdom saving throw. I don't go north, but something in my head told me to go north. Alright, I'm going to stealth run. Wait, I'm just going to get a normal stealth, which is fine. Alright, I'm going to run past him. I'm going to go ahead and pick the first lock, which I'm at advantage now. Because.
Why do you have the lock?
I don't know. No, but remember there's two locks.
Oh, yeah.
So actually, I only get +5 to my lock pick, which is right here, Thieves' Tools. Let's see if it'll actually give me my math right. So this is the normal lock. It did not add the plus 5. So that's 21. That would pick the lock. And then I would unlock the lock with the second lock.
The trickery is still there in there, right?
What?
The trickery lock is still there?
Yes.
Okay, just double checking.
But you got to remember, we don't know who has the key. I drop off my notes about the Grim Statue. I drop off the notes about... I'm going to put in the notes... Oh, I know what I'm doing. Since I'm in the safe room and I locked the door, I'm going to create a magic mouth on the other side of the door for whenever a Memento Mori or a Shield and Shroud Recovery ring is within 5 feet of this. I'm going to utter the words, Menel was here. And that might give them the idea that there are notes inside the safe house.
There might be. Oh, it's always going to be there, though, right?
Yeah.
Since
the note's there. What I'll do is I'll take a long rest here.
Yeah, that's probably the safest spot you're going to be in. Yeah.
All right. So...
I can just imagine him sleeping under the desk.
What do you mean? There's a tent. There's some bed rolls.
Yeah, do you trust that tent, though?
One second. Sorry, my dog's going a little nuts. We do, but I need help. Alright, sorry about that. Alright, so I'm going to do hit rolls for my long rest. I got two random encounters coming in. Let's see what they are. At hour 3. Give me a second. All right, so there are and they have no way of opening the door. So I'm good. We'll see what the hour 5 is.
What time did you go in?
I went around night.
Again? Okay. I'm just curious if you're going to see that guy or not.
All right. They're going to be this way. So there will be a battle outside.
What hours are these at?
The hour three, the wasps would have moved on.
Okay. So I was thinking, I was like, would there be?
Alistair really needs to do something about that wasp problem.
Yeah. They got loose from area three or floor three, you know.
And then I here actually would be on this one because I can't get to that side. I would hear basically what sounds like a... Oh, actually, hold on. Would I be able to hear them? Oh, yeah. I could definitely hear what sounds like a small army in plate armor on the other side.
A little restless, but we're still good.
So we're still good. They would march off after a few hours. I don't know which direction they'll go. They go north. Ah, sweet. All right.
What are you going to do?
I have no fucking clue. All right. What do I got here? I got all my spells back. I have on me. I'll make notes of hearing wasps and what sounds like an army in armor, full plate armor. I'll make some more notes in the emerald with the emerald pen.
Alright. Can you leave it in the chest?
Yep. I'll just add it to the notes that I made. So I will do... What did we do that? Let's see. Do I have anything else? Oh, how many spikes did I use? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Give me 1 second. I want to look. Remember how many I did because I got to take spikes off. Five plus 6, 11. That's 11. That'll put us at 34. Oh, thank you. All right. So. I could do. Let's see if I go.
You do know that we may have cleared zombies and/or bandits in the north from Pethrall and.
Yeah, them. But he really does not like undead.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like I'm pretty sure you would have heard that. You've been through the Hall of Mirrors and kind of investigated that already.
Yep.
The only other direction you really haven't gone is south.
Which I have gone south once. I left a gold piece on the ledge.
Right, and that's about it. So right. You don't really have many other choices, but...
Yep. These guys are never there.
All you right. Gonna have fun with the alligator again.
Let's see. I'm thinking about that, actually. I didn't like the ghost... In the mirrors. I might go south.
My money's on north. And you just kind of stealthily go around everything.
But it's undead. I hate undead.
Yeah. But would curiosity beat undead?
No. There's more I can do. Alright. Fuck it. So... I'm going to go up.
It?
Nope. I'm going to go up. I'm going to drop off the the notes.
All right. So you're going to leave them in the chest, or you can just bring them up?
I always do two copies of notes.
Okay, just double checking.
So I'm at 14. I'll go up. I'll first unlock the door again. I will lock the first lock, the lock of trickery, and then I will attempt to lock the other door. I don't. Lock of trickery is enough right now. So I will leave. But I will go back down the whatchamacallit. Can I get, do we have rope at the guild?
We can make it from the thing, I think.
Rope's
under 10 gold, right?
I'd have to look. Let's see, rope.
You better hope Gaz is up still after 8 hours.
eight. That'd be.
It would be morning by then. You probably.
It'd be 10 hours. So yeah, I would be morning right now. So what I'll do is, it is a gold piece for hemp rope. I need two ropes.
Easy. We'll pull both of them out.
All right. I will go. So I immediately drop off the notes. I go back down yet again.
I'm glad we have this chest for useless things like this.
So there's, yeah, so I drop off notes. I'm like, hey guys, sorry, it was a while. Drops off notes. I need a rope. Okay,
thanks.
I need two ropes. Thank you so much. I'll be back. Hopefully, and he just goes back down. I could just picture the guild like, that guy's still alive?
Oh, gosh, just gives you a thumbs up. And like, do you need any heals or anything? Oh, wait, do you want to, actually, you know what I forgot to do is pour you a drink. Do you want a drink?
You poured me the drink already for the initial. You do not have enough time for it to lapse and pour me another drink.
I think it's still done, isn't it?
Well, the next day I do go at night, so yeah.
Yeah, well, I have to pour you another drink.
Well, give me 1 second. I want to look at it. I want to look at the magic item again. Dragon. What's the item called again?
Something slumbering dragon.
Slumbering. Thank you, slumbering. Vessel.
It's the better. It might be slumbering, or it might be the better.
Oh, until the next dawn. So it is dawn.
It is dawn. So you need another pour.
I can get another potion. So
which one did you want?
I'm taking the big one because I drank the big one going down.
Okay, grabs two hemp ropes from chest and pours greater healing.
Yep. So I got my 100 feet of rope again.
I'm changing it right now. So.
Yep. And I can get my potion, which is 44 plus 4. So I'm just going to add random item really quick. Add loot. New loot. I'll just call it Uber Potion. Super Potion. Alright. That way I don't have to. So. I talk to the prophets. I laugh. I'm like, hi, I'm back. I need to go back down. Funny story. I need to go back down. They just look at me.
Are you going back down the way you went?
Yes.
Okay, weirdo.
By the way, I look even worse now because I've been struck by lightning once.
Don't worry, you still have your fake eyebrows.
I'm still very singed. My hair still smells like it's My hair always smells like I've just recently caught fire.
We'll get you a smoldering chest plate or something. Oh, we can't even do that because you have that. Okay.
Yep. I will lower myself back down. Put it through the two rings, and then I can just make the little elevator back down. All right. So I gotta just not fuck this up. All right. So I am plus 100.
I'm more surprised you didn't put a gold piece down for their luck.
I didn't want to go back through that room.
Yeah.
Plus, the only way I could go down is through those ghouls that were there last time that I saw again. And I just don't want to deal with them. So, I'm going to go down. Athletics at advantage because I'm elevatoring myself down. Down 25. I go do it again. It's only 5 feet. A little bit more, and I'm on the head. I'm at 15. Oh, not that. I'm at 50. I will from here, because there's three pittons on the neck of the statue now. And noticing the chain is slightly glowing from all the stuff going through it, and then I'm gonna realize that this isn't gonna hold. So what I will do is realize that this will not hold and take more notes, write it in my lovely book, write them in two sheets of paper yet again. And then I'm going to start to lower myself down on the right good side now.
You know, it'd be funny. Put a note on one of the pittons.
All right. Ooh, so bad news is I am in the bad zone now. So chain is still here, but it still will arc to one of these. So mostly arc to these, but it has a chance to arc one of these. Also, the spikes are going to be glowing a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and start lowering myself down the backside. Good, that's fine. 35, you know. Continue to lower myself. Ooh, hold on. Do I get struck by lightning? Do not get struck by lightning. Thank God. All right. Lower myself a little bit more. That's only 10. So I lower myself down again. 10 feet off the ground. Oh, hold on. Do I get struck by lightning? Nope. All right. I'm at 10. I'm going to lower myself yet again. And do I get struck by lightning? Nope. So I'm back on the ground. I will immediately run. Outside the circle, which I still have the chance of getting shot. Oh, so close. Good. Did not get struck. All right. Open the door. I hear the noise that Menel went west. I'm gonna go north this time. Wait. Let me stealth again. gonna go back down. I'm gonna spend another 10 minutes to cast another one that says Menel went north. Keep going. I'm gonna stealth one more time just to be sure. Oh yeah, I'm golden. Oh look, it's me again. From here, I'm gonna cast yet another spell. Ritual. Menel went west. Oh, stealth. Okay, so I'm down to two casts of that.
Yeah, bet.
And then I'm back into the the lovely nest area. Yeah, whatever. No. Do that. So I go north. I see what looks like a bench, which I will then immediately become even more cautious and stealth. It looks like a magic circle of some sort. And being here, I would just sit here for a long time, staring at the magic circle to make sure nothing happens with the magic circle. Looks like I'm going west. Because it was south, west, north. I'll continue to sneak. Oh yeah, I'm stealthy. And now we light. That's new. Alright, so if there's light there, and I really don't want to go in front of that light, I'm going to listen to the door. I'm going to open the door. Wait, no, I'm going to open the door because I keep forgetting to check the doors. Hallway. Close the door. Wait. Nope, I'm gonna go this way. Everyone knows I wouldn't go through the light. There's another door and a door. I'm gonna listen to this door. Nothing on that side of the door that I can hear. I'm going to listen to see if I can hear anything on this side of the door. Do I hear anything? No. To open this door very stealthily. And the moment that I see light with two torches, what looks like a bear trap, a a pile of bones and a giant bloody handprint.
Are you where I think you are?
Yep.
Okay.
I am not gonna fuck with that.
He's not in Kansas anymore, boys.
There's dead people in there. I'm just gonna close that and move on. Oh, dead people. What could possibly... I'm gonna listen to this door. Do I hear anything? No, I do not. Goes up. I'm gonna stealth again. Fritz, there's specific ones that I... Alright.
Stealth. Bad, what a miss.
Not much.
There's not very many trapdoors in Undermountain.
He went back up.
Yeah,
that's true. Right. He went back up, got some shit, then went back down again. Through the same
so,
way.
Alright.
I have come to a crossroads of what looks like a wall covered in graffiti. The floor is covered in graffiti. And the ceiling is covered in graffiti with the word traitor. I will make notes of this. I will make notes.
You should make note of the empty room.
Of an empty room just past the graffiti in charcoal that says traitor. I'm not gonna fuck with a room that is empty. That just screams like it's not empty.
I'm gonna
investigate to the north. That's definitely a wall. I'm going to investigate to the west.
Where the graffiti is.
That is definitely a wall. All right. I will make note of graffiti. I will spend time right here writing notes about graffiti. Oh, I forgot to close my door. How careless of me. Close the door. I'm going to stealth again. Door there. I'm going to listen to what's beyond this door. Nothing on the other side of the door. I'm going to open the door. I'm going to see a toilet. I'm immediately going to close the door. Sneak up to it. Stealth. I'm gonna listen to the door. Look on our side. I peek inside. And it's a janitor's closet.
Whoa, who knew?
I'm going to close the door. Just going to look around, not touch anything, but I'll probably just sit and make some notes about a janitor's closet to the west. Up. I'm too far, actually. Control C. Yeah, I'm too far. I need to go to copy this guy really quick. Did I hit past the purple? Yeah, past the purple. That's on me. That is Oh, I know what zone this is. KOS. All right, so I am right here. So I do see another door. Peek around the corner with my stealth. Not so stealthy. I noticed that the stone is not so... not in the best condition going south. Maybe crushing. I'll take a listen to the door. But okay, I'll open the door. And as soon as I see blood on the ground and skulls literally lining the hall, which I need to see if they hear me. Nope. Oh, thank God. I'm going to immediately stealthily close the door. Okay.
I think after that you would know to just stealthily open things and close things.
Yep, I'm going to go back to my room. I will attempt to lock the door.
That doesn't help you at all.
Lock it. And I'm going to make notes of skulls. Hall of skulls, hall, lots and lots of blood, bad things.
Why is it right next to the janitor's closet?
And it's right next to the janitor's closet.
It's a work in progress, all right? He's working on it.
Why do you think there's a janitor's? Because he needs it close by to clean it every time.
This is a forward operating janitor's closet. He hasn't ventured into all the rooms. All right.
He just sees all the blood and skull. He's like, yep.
Well, that's what's
the night guy.
What's to say every time he goes into the janitor's closet and tries to come out, it doesn't like magically make one where he needs to clean up shit, you know?
Well, true. All right. I'm going
to. He should be able to teleport through janitor's closet to janitor's closet.
Oh my God. Can you? Oh, I love that.
All right, we gotta put that in a note now.
All right, so very long hallway. I am gonna, since the stone is like cracked, I'm gonna perceive up ahead because I would think that something might be crushing the ground and things like that. And it's like, nope, nope, it looks good. I'm scared, but it looks good.
Maybe that's not a stealth roll.
Oh yeah, give me a stealth roll. Good there. Three sets of doors. I need to consult a new book because I might be dead.
Let me see. Where are you at anyway in the dungeon? I can't even tell anymore.
50A. This might actually get me killed. Because I would
look here, guys. Not every part of the dungeon's configured correctly. Okay, there's a lot of things that can kill you here.
I peek down that way. There's four doors. All right, 50A. Base camp. All right. Okay. I would definitely, definitely not touch this door. I will hug the wall. So,
would you know that though?
Oh yeah, no. There's the main reason. I'm gonna give you the description of the doors. Okay, we all know the doors are stone doors. So, This passageway's western walls has three identical doors etched in the word "Enter Here" in common. The doors do not appear to have locks. These doors also appear to be metal.
Yeah, you wouldn't touch those doors with a fucking, with a 10-foot pole.
I will back away slowly.
What's in those rooms? I don't know. Who knows?
I will write notes on metal doors that are obvious traps.
Wait, you don't want to keep going down the hallway?
I will. Oh, I'm hugging the wall like no tomorrow.
He's like crunk.
I don't want to go. This is a standard door. Right here, so I feel a lot more comfortable
approaching after the door. Three metal doors? That could be the trap door.
Exactly. I'm going to get fucked here. Watch. All right. I don't hear anything beyond the door. I'm going to open the door.
Like a fool.
Peek my head inside. Alright, so what is this? I just want to double check.
Okay, I think I know where you're at, but I don't know how close
you are. As you round the corner, you hear trickling water looking west. Let's see, so.
Oh, you are close to the place I think you are.
I would be going towards trickling water, which apparently is quite a ways away. Stealth. Going towards the noise. Peeking. Alright, I hear the noise. Alright. Looking west, you see a large fountain set into the wall, carved into a pixie holding its breath, plugging its nose with its hands. Water squirts from the pixie's ears. The water falling from the fountain is clear, but as it nears the basin, it takes a green, light green hue that rapidly darkens to deep green before turning into a sickening brown the moment it splashes into the basin. So the water is shooting out. It's clear. The water is changing colors as it's falling down. And it becomes a sickly brown as it hits the water.
Oh, lovely.
That looks like delicious water.
I would drink from the ear, not from the pond. Anything living in it?
I'm not going to get near the obviously sickly water. Room's empty-ish. I'm going to make notes. I'll spend time to make notes. I will actually sit and watch the fountain for about, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes, see if the color changes at all. It doesn't. I'll sit. And then I will cast Goodberry. Pop one of those in my mouth.
Oh, well.
And take a drink from my decanter. Wait, I have an idea.
Oh no, what is he doing? What are you doing?
I'm gonna go towards it. And from a distance, can I do this? I will say give the option for fountain to shoot water into the fountain.
You can't try to shoot water into the fountain.
I'm basically gonna just shoot it into the fountain to see if the water from my decanter. Well, first I would pour myself a gallon.
Just in case.
just in case, and then I will shoot water to see if my water changes colors going into the fountain. So this is going to make some noise.
Will it?
Oh, yeah. It's all right.
It just sounds like you're peeing.
Trick shot from across the room.
Yeah, from 15 feet away.
I got this. After that, I will stealth. All right. Still not touching those fucking doors. And then, copy.
So those two rooms just had a fountain in the, or an empty room?
Yep.
Okay.
All right. And immediately I would begin to notice that the floor is starting to grow moss in between the cracks. That's new. Before I even get near those, I'm going to start making more notes on that. Around the corner, it goes way down there. There's a door. I'm gonna listen to the door. I hear roaring fire. Long way down. Oops, sorry. It just looks like random pottery and a bunch of dead lizard people and 49A. Two lizard folk, two dwarves, a half-orc, and a half-elf lie slain in the chamber. The room is filled with smashed pottery and other stoneware. While shards look like they were destroyed long ago, the mortal carnage is fresh. To the west, it's a door revealing the passageway. Let's see, to south, it descends into a stairwell. I'm going to just peek around the stairs.
You'd be scared about the dead bodies.
But they're laying there dead. They look dead. They look dead dead. I'm way out of my depth here. I look down the stairs and there's more dead bodies. I don't like this. I'm not gonna touch those bodies with the 10-foot pole. I will take note of the carnage.
And go deeper where the might be more carnage?
Shh. Get your logic out of here. Stealth check. Oh, yeah. I'm stealthy. Peek around the corner. We now have a small bush growing out. And it's like getting humider and humider as I go in. I'm going to perceive this door. Go ahead. Open the door. See that there's another door. Not that's what we call an airlock. Avoid the touching the bushes. And is this seriously not? I'm in Legends of the Hidden Temple. I am seriously missing a door. This is good to know.
Whoops.
This is good to know. I can't remember how to do this fucking trick. Alt. Okay, that's how it works. All right. That's good to know. I'm going to go fix that in the master copy. Door. Door. Lizards? Giant lizards? Give me my stealth really quick. Oh, yeah. They didn't see me. I'm gonna go.
They found your lizard folk.
I'm gonna listen to this door. Oh, open it. It's all water and bone. Nope. Nope. I don't want to be out in the open. Nope. I'm going back.
I don't think I'm in back entrances left.
I definitely not going through the double doors. That's just bad news. I'm just going to keep going. There's dead bodies. I'm going to close the door behind me. Sneak through the dead bodies.
Stealth check.
Yep, there's my stealth. Hear a roaring inferno of a fire, and there's a door here. Okay. So, could go all the way back around. I don't like the blood skulls area. I would have to go past the metal doors again, or I could keep going on. Interesting. These are all dead. Oh, I remember what happens. So these I actually need to get off here, and these get off here. I remember how you're supposed to run this. So basically, nope. So basically what would happen is the moment that I open this door here, so perception. I peek out, I see a big room. I would then hear running behind me. With a pursuit in place. If I hear the running. I hear the running. I would close the door. I'm gonna go north. I see a door. I would just keep running. Quiet, and then immediately see a giant room that I just stepped in. Oh, fuck me. All right.
Oh, I remember this room. Go look for that room.
I don't have much time because I heard running behind me. I closed the door. I'll pull 50 feet of rope and throw it across.
You still have 50 feet?
It's in. I elevated it. So you you put it through the pitons and you lower yourself down. So you're basically tied off, and you like slowly elevator yourself down, and then you can just pull the other side of the rope and pull it through the loop. So that's a way to keep the 100 feet of rope.
Gotcha.
So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw the rope across. I'm gonna see if I have the strength to do so. I do. I throw it to about here. It will get about there. So we'll get 1, 2 traps. I will acrobatics now. Make sure I can just avoid these. To this point, pull out my other 50 feet of rope. Try to throw it across.
You're walking on the rope?
No. The rope, as soon as it hits the thing, it would set him off.
Oh, all of them? Okay.
Oh, no. Nope. That wouldn't happen. That would not happen. I'm just going to be a complete dick. Do I have anything on me?
There's other stuff on them, right? Besides just bear traps?
They're all bear traps.
Yeah, but there's other stuff, right?
No.
Oh, I thought there was supposed to be more stuff there.
Nope. It's just like 100 bear traps. Okay. I will take a torch and drop it into each one.
Okay. One. I thought there was supposed to be caltrops and stuff like that.
Nope.
You can't see very well.
1, 2, 3. How many torches do I got?
We'll pick them up and start tossing them.
Well, they're like getting snapped in half.
You can still use the snap sub.
Yeah. 3, 4, 5, 6. I'd walk this way. 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep, 10 torches. I'll keep one because that's my poking stick. North with a stealth. Check this way. Immediately here that Menel went west. Realize where I'm at. And this brings me back to the nest.
Sorry.
Let's see. So Menel went west. Right there. Just dragging my body over. Right back here. I will go north. I will cast the second spell. I will cast a second spell right here. So as soon as they're going to hear Menel went west, I will cast a second spell.
You also could dismiss it, can't you?
No, I'm just going to cast it. I'm going to have him say, no, don't go that way. and then say Menel went north. So, no, don't go that way. And then say Menel went north. Stealth. And this is probably where I die. Right here.
Oh no, you gotta find out. And here's the trap you probably won't notice.
Yep. So this is gonna happen. Which immediately we'll close this off.
You gonna jump?
I have to see if I react. I would. I could try to jump behind. I'll try to jump behind. Saving throw. I'll leave him in there. Fuck it. I'll leave him in there.
Gonna stay still?
Okay. No, and then this would appear. He can't see me, but I'm standing on top of him. So he can feel me. He's gonna attempt to smother me. I'm gonna have advantage.
What do you have advantage?
Because he can't see me.
Oh, but he can feel you though.
He can feel me. Okay, so all right, so he get the smother off then. This is for me. I make it. I see it stand up. And now all I can do is fight. So radiant.
Did you climb the wall or something?
No, it's literally, it seals you in a 10 foot by 10 foot by 10 foot space.
Okay.
So I'd stab at it. Miss horribly. It would. I have advantage on these now, because it can't really. Well, can
you can still. You're still on top.
Wait, no. Never mind. No, I don't have advantage. This thing has fucking blindsight.
Oh wait, so it can.
It can see me.
So it does have advantage on that roll.
And I'm smothered. I attempt to break free. Which is an acrobatics. Nope. I get crushed.
What breaks?
A lot. So I'm going to take... Oof. So 20 damage.
This is the end of Menel.
This is the end of Menel right here. What breaks? Potions. They're all in the bag of holding. So we're good.
You're good, yeah.
Short bow. Breaks. Or long bow breaks.
Do you have any weapons left then?
I have 2 short swords.
Okay.
Which are metal. I'm fucked. All right, I will attempt to break free. Which the smother is a DC 14. I'm dead. 9. Yep, that's the end of Menel right there. So he gets eaten.
Bye, Menel.
And that's it.
Well, Menel did pretty well. What? What about his body?
So, I'm trying to remember. This guy, it's a pile of bones. It's going to be ghillie style.
okay.
So a pile of bones. yeah, he's pretty much gonna dissolve a lot of things, and then it is on a actual major highway.
Yeah, if they go the right direction.
Yep. So there's not gonna be really any loot.
Unless the orcs go see it.
Yep, and the orcs will find it. And they'll probably, yeah. So basically, these guys would have my loot.
But with the, they know about the trapper and the trap?
Oh, yeah.
That's true, okay. Yeah, and a lot of people fight for those guys, so.
Because they would hear actually the loud boom right. of the stone. And they would probably investigate after the... Because after a certain amount of time, the things go back up. And they bring enough of a squad to come through that the trapper won't attack.
Right.
So it would be a pile of bones. Let's see if my magic... But luckily, they cannot decipher any of my notes.
Right. But they what they're going to do with a pen?
All right. So I'll have to run through and see. Yeah.
Oh, damn. They still have that one character too, right?
Yep. So, yeah. That's the end of Menel right there. You guys did get a bunch of notes, though.
Yeah.
Out of him. It does further the story. But, yeah. That's rough.
You know, the worst part is they're going to go... People are going to go that down that direction. And get messed with. With that trapper.
Because, yeah, I did say... Well... I did say, but yeah, they'll probably run into the trapper.
Each if time they don't now. Get crushed by the thing.
Yeah. Because, yeah, my character would have been just slowly moving forward as stealthy as possible. He wouldn't be in a good position to actually react to the falling.
All right, what's the next character?
Hold on. We gotta do this.
The rest of the stream is just us making another character.
197.
Menel was 197?
Yep.
Confirmed 197.
Yeah.
He wasn't quite 200, but he was close.
Yep. I don't want to be 200. All right, let's see. Oh shit, Southwick, you're right.
What? That about the acid?
Let's see. Bag of holding. It survives. So they would find the bag of holding and all the loot.
What about all the stuff that was on you? So like I know the pen was one too and all that.
The pen is always in the bag.
Oh, okay.
Like pretty much I carry a light load. So I have to let's just go through since alright. So short sword.
You would have that on your side. Bow's gone.
Yep. So let's just see if the acid dissolves it. It's dissolved. So done. This does not have the resistance. Done. Bag of holding did survive. Boots of Elvenkind survived. Cloak of Elvenkind did not. The spell infusion ring survived, which it would lose its power. Gloves of Thievery survived. goggles of object reading, dissolve, his eyebrows turn into a needle, but it disappears, so done. The serpent scale armor.
I hope that dissolves.
Dissolves. Decanter of endless water. Is in the bag of holding. The emerald pen. The wand of magic missiles is good.
Yeah. Okay. I would see that on you for sure, just in case.
Oh yeah, it was on me. That's why I'm asking if it's dissolving. And then my potion is dead. So everything else, oh, thieves' tools are always on my side, are good. So we'll just say dead. My quiver dies.
Is next warlock?
Was that?
What's your next character? Warlock?
I think it was a warlock, yeah. Dissolved. Everything else is in the bag of holding, which the bag of holding survives. And Menel or Southwick gets his objective completed.
Oh, what was that?
I can't talk about it.
I gotcha.
But you guys still do have a copy of it.
Yes, we do.
Alright. That's that. Yeah. So I'm going to go ahead. This is going to be very interesting because all of this loot goes to these guys. Probably these guys because they're the closest. And guess what? Guess where 8-Bit is right now?
In that room.
Yeah. In that room. That'll be very interesting.
She's right next to the body of Menel.
Yep. So, yeah, that's that. All right, I'm going to wrap it up here. I got some stuff to fix, actually. I did find some stuff to... Yeah. All right. Well, I'm going to wrap it up here. Menel died. The notes... are in the bag of holding, which will be very interesting because only people who have signed the guild charter can actually read it.
It's only those people?
Okay. Yep. And yeah, everything's in the bag of holding, and that survived. Same with the letters and all the other fun stuff. Yep. Alright. Fucking cereal crushed.
Both things. It was a fucking a random cereal crusher.
Freaking cereal. Yep. I mean, solos are meant, like, I learned a few things about the dungeon. Solos are fun. I do like attacking it on trying a solo run. And now trying to do a solo run without any of that knowledge.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. A trapper against a solo, you're always going to die pretty much.
Unless you have decent enough escapability.
Actually, you know what? I'm really, really glad I got the Emerald Pen before I did this. Because all of my notes are encrypted to all non-guild members.
Right.
So, yeah. That'll... Yeah. I got some writing to do now. And we now have a week. I am debating on possibly running a duo or a solo run for somebody else coming up.
Right.
But I gotta go through the VOD now and see what notes I put in. You know, write up the notes.
Right.
And then I have to put little things on the map now for wherever the magic mouth is. It's gonna be so funny. They're like, Menel went west. And then they walk 5 feet to the left and they're like, no, no, no. Menel went north. Menel went north. Oh.
They're like good old Menel.
Oh. But yeah, Serial Crusher is brutal. That's why I love him so much. It is a very brutal killer, especially if they get separated and then run into one of them. A trapper is just gonna murder them. All right. Let's see. You know what? I'm gonna watch the world. I'm gonna not give away my passwords.
Shouldn't. I don't even know.
All right. Come on. All right, so we were in Legends of the Hidden Temple. The walls, yep. No door there. Try to remember how I did this. Nope, that's not it. How did I lock this again?
Mm.
All right. That's not it. That's definitely not it. Come on. How did I do this? Man, I haven't drawn a map in forever. Yeah, that's not it. Is it it's not control, it's not shift.
Which world are you gonna go?
Not, I just did this fucking. Okay.
Yeah, hired decks. Oh yeah, I do. But even Menel had a decent one and still died.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and end the stream here while I figure out how to lock them to the freaking corners again. All right, you all have a good one, and I will talk to you all later.
Bye.